Welcome to this video playing Pont du Jour, if this is halfway right pronounced. I haven't played him for a while, but it's a very frequent opponent. He's 13 games in, no draws. Oh, d6, after the, I wanted to go, yeah, okay. I don't want so much d6 e5 against bishop e2, I don't like that very much. So I'm trying to do something different here. I have wanted to, should have played maybe a Grünfeld type of setup. Let's see, this is a bit weird, but not that bad. Trying to get a little bit stuff traded and increase the pressure on on d4. Yeah, bishop, that if he takes on e4, let's say, this bishop on e4 helps a little bit to increase pressure on the d-pawn. Yeah, and it seems to gain a bit of time on the clock. Seems he was not really expecting this move. I wonder, is there something great instead of just taking? I mean, or is he just disconnected? No, now he took. Okay. Okay, I'm going to take the knight and then knight c6 for. I can take on d4. On knight c6. Knight c6 takes knight e5. Not sure. No, but it's not bad, right? I mean, the long diagonal is opened up. There's some point to that. If he takes it, the question is knight e5 or not. Oh, he advanced. So knight e5, I guess. Yeah, I wonder if a Benko-like setup is in order or not. I'm going to take and prepare b5. Yeah, now let's go b5. a2 hangs, so... Okay, just plays it in a simple fashion. Let's see, I'm attacking the pawn. Why can I not take the pawn? Is he trapping my queen? I don't see it. Check. I can give the check on c3, but I have e2. I can take here first. Let's do that. And I also just have rook b8, by the way. Yeah, that's also not a bad idea. Sorry. I'm a bit quicker here on the b-file. Still have a2 attacked, and he still does not take it. So what is the problem? I know I'm taking it. Queen c3, check f6, rook a1, queen b2. I don't get it. I think I could have taken it before, but I wasn't totally sure. Yeah, I don't see any very substantial play for him. Maybe like e5, trying to open up the e-file and the dark squares a bit. But Not sure that it is very dangerous, though.
Check.
Okay, f6 is a move that I think I'm okay with. Just also blocking e5, that's not happening. Take, take. Yeah, rook a1, I have rook b1, and I'm winning 2 pawns. e4 will fall. I'm threatening a rook b3, which would push the queen back to e1. Yeah, that looks like a win, really. Rook b3 is a pretty big threat.
White resigns.
Yeah, and he's down on 1 minute. Yeah, I don't know. That looked quite comfortable here, but I shouldn't be as quickly taking over as I did. I don't know here. Rook b1, b5. So that looks normal. Computer suggests b4. That's an interesting idea, making use of the rook on b1. That's okay for white. That's okay. And something like this is just equal. Yeah, I think he should do something a little bit more active. And here I think I can take, but I wasn't totally sure. Like, we think about this kind of thing.
Check.
Let's say here, here, rook a1, queen e2, and then I was thinking, okay, maybe he can go f3 or something, and then, yeah, I have b4. Yeah, I'm just about untangling here. B4 here and there. But okay, I didn't want to get my queen trapped. I recently had my queen trapped in a game, in a blitz game. It was kind of awkward. And here I'm just safe and okay. I mean, okay, e4 just gives away the pawn. It was kind of mysterious. He can play queen c2 or a3 or whatever. Yeah, now I'm taking
check.
It. There's absolutely nothing there. So that was interesting in the opening here. Here I can also take. That also was interesting. Queen takes knight d7, threatening knight c5. But I wasn't completely sure about this position. I'm better developed, but he's got the two bishops. Yeah, I think it's equalish. This my position is very active and the knight will have a good place on c5, so I'm not worse. Okay, thanks for watching.